So I did a video recently where I had a Roval front wheel and the bearing seemed a bit tight. And so I put in the work stand and went to spin the wheel and it didn't freely spin. It was smooth, but it didn't want to freely spin. And then I compared it to another DT Swiss wheel, hubbed wheel that I had, and that spun freely. Now, in the comments, people were saying that, oh, you need to put the thru axle, you need to tighten the thru axle in the fork to 10 newton meters, and then then the wheel will all be good. I'm not quite so sure about that. That didn't seem like the difference was going to be sufficient. Anyway, that wheel, the original wheel with the tight bearings, that went back to the customer, so I couldn't test that. However, I did have another one come in, so another Roval wheel, the same model. So I decided to test this one and see how it compared to the first one, and also did that in the work stand in the wheel building jig, but then put it in a fork and torqued up the thru axle to 10 newton meters. And so we did that with this wheel and also with the other DT Swiss wheel that I also tested in the previous video. So what we've got is we've got both of those wheels being tested in the park wheel building jig, and then in a fork torqued up to 10 newton meters. So before we go to the new wheel, let's just have a refresher on the other wheel that we tested in the park stand and the wheel building jig. And as you can see, it really did not want to turn freely. The bearings were tight, so yeah, you can see its resistance to movement. So now we've got the other wheel. Now, this is the same model wheel, the same hub, but you can see it's still not rotating really well, but it's better than the other one from the other time. So, you know, it's much smoother. So we'll take it out of the park stand. And we'll put the other DT Swiss wheel that we used in the other video with the built on the MB wheel, that's a DT240, and that's clearly spinning very easily. Like that's, you can tell that the rim itself is out of balance because it's going on its own accord. So, you know, there's a big difference between those two hubs in their rolling resistance. You know, with a very light touch, the wheel just continues to spin under its own out of balance, which is another topic in itself. We can talk about that another time. So now we've put the wheel into the fork. So the fork's mounted in the park wheel building jig just to support it. But I'm tightening up the thru axle there with just a normal 6mm Allen key, and I'll grab the torque wrench, which is set to 10 newton meters, and tighten up that thru axle to the 10 newton meter spec, and let's see how it turns once it's loaded up. Check it a couple of times with the torque setting. Okay, let's have a look. Still not great, is it? Hasn't really made much difference at all compared to how it was just in the park stand. So it certainly hasn't transformed the wheel to be anything like the other DT Swiss wheel was just in the park stand on its own. So let's take this wheel out, and we'll put the DT the other DT Swiss wheel in with the Envy build on the DT240, and we'll torque that up in the same way. So we'll just put the thru axle in, just orientate the wheel right so the disc side lines up. Slide the thru axle in. We'll nip it up with a 6mm. And then get the torque wrench in the same way as before. Here we go, the torque wrench still set to 10 newton meters. And we'll check it. And there it goes. Okay. And it's just moving under its own imbalance again. So it hasn't changed this hub at all either. It's rotating as freely as it did before. So anyway, it doesn't seem to be making much of a difference for these wheels. I mean, I do understand the theory that preloading the axle, and I remember the old Durace cup and cone hubs, having to adjust those just a little bit looser when you do the quick release skewer up, compressing the axle a little bit. But there doesn't seem to be much difference with these two hubs. So I don't know, you tell me. So as you can see in those spin tests, there's a difference between the wheel that I posted recently and the one I've got here now. So two different wheels, and they both had different drag in the Park wheel building gear. You also noticed that there didn't seem to be much difference between the Park wheel building jig, the way the wheel was rotating in the Park jig, and the way it was rotating in a fork with the thru axle tightened up to 10 newton meters. So visibly there wasn't any major difference between the way they were rolling in either of the wheels. And in the other DT Swiss wheel, as a reference or control, if you like there was basically no difference no visible difference in the way the wheel was spinning in the Park stand or in a fork with the thru axle tightened up. Now, I've actually got I built a system years ago, which I can get out again, where I had a rotary encoder to actually measure the bearing resistance. Now, we could run through all that again, there's a lot of work in doing that, but and then get a definitive answer, and you may be able to see a very small difference between a Park wheelbuilding stand and tightening up to the 10 newton meters on the thru axle in a fork. But visibly I didn't see much difference. And yeah, I mean, let me know in the comments, but I mean, you've seen the video, it didn't look to be a significant difference tightening the axle in a fork in terms of changing the wheel. So the biggest difference was the difference between the first wheel that I tested the other day, which unfortunately I don't have to retest, and the second identical model wheel. So there's quite a difference between those. Anyway, let me know in the comments. Always happy to put things to the test. So, yeah, we'll see you next time.